Hi there, welcome to the Uke Stuff channel. Today I'm just going to record a short video comparing the Flight NUT-310 with the NUB-310. I recently reviewed this instrument. I reviewed this one some time ago, and I just wanted to talk about the differences while I still have this. In short, I ordered a Flight Gemstone used from Amazon, not from Flight directly, but from Amazon, and what showed up instead of the Flight Gemstone was the Flight NUT-310. So somebody did a switcheroo and I think lied to the company and stole a much more expensive instrument, sending it back. Okay, that all said, this one's going back today, but before I send it back, I want to talk about these two instruments and what the differences are. So if you're interested in all at this entry-level Flight series, you're getting really great value from a established brand that uses a dealer network where you can get support from your local dealer, the dealer can get support from the distributor, and the distributor can get support from the company. I know that doesn't match the ship it now global brand idea where a company in China just ships directly to the customer that buys it, but there are really awesome benefits from buying from a local dealer. You keep that dealer in business. You can buy accessories there. If there are things that go wrong, you have somebody to talk to that can help you work it out. There's some real positives there, and you develop a relationship over time. They can help you with your growth, get you materials that you need. There's some real positives about using a local dealer rather than just Amazon. Now, I also don't mind buying from Amazon because I do some of that setup myself, and I also have local dealers that I know that if I need something, I can go and visit too. But that all said, this one came. So the review is very good for this instrument. It's really cleanly made, sounds great. But what I wanted to talk about today was sort of just comparing these two. And I do not have any others of this Natural series at the moment. At some point, I do want to buy an NUC-310 and review it, because that probably is one of Flight's most popular models beyond their travel series. Great starter uke, concert. Some people get intimidated by tenor, which they shouldn't. But I just wanted to talk about a few of the things. First of all, the styling is exactly the same. So if you check out the headstocks, they both share the same headstock. If you check out the bodies, the baritone and the tenor have slightly different designs, but they both have walnut fretboards. They both have walnut bridges, they both have bone saddles, they both have bone nuts. And the one thing that you'll see different is I am running baritone strings on the NUB-310, and they are living water fluorocarbon strings. I like fluorocarbon strings. If I was going to keep this one, it would be switched to probably Flight's fluorocarbon strings at this point. But what you need to know is that the Flight NUB-310 is shipped with GCEA strings that are not so dissimilar from these. These are not Aquilas. These are Flight sort of nylon-based strings that work well. I'm just not a fan of nylon-based strings, so I almost always switch to fluorocarbon. The other thing I wanted to mention is that both of these have a truss rod. So you can see the truss rod on the tenor, and then you can see the truss rod on the baritone. A lot of baritones do come with a truss rod. A lot of tenors do not. So that's kind of interesting to see. The other thing that I know from looking at the inside of these is that the tenor is traditionally built and you've got cross braces. Okay, this one has an X brace. I don't think you'll ever see it in the light, but the top is supported with an X that's sort of more like guitar construction. A lot of guitars use that X brace instead. And that's really probably, other than pure size, the big functional difference. If you're looking at nut width, they're almost identical. The neck dimensions are almost identical. You just have a longer neck, of course, on the baritone versus a tenor. So I'm just gonna play them both real quick for you and wrap up this video. Just thought it was worth talking about the two instruments and just letting you see them. So here's the tenor a little bit. For release. that one little wrong note there. Now, let's switch over to the baritone. And again, this is gonna be a total different experience because you're dealing with fluorocarbon strings and now DGBE tuning. But just gives you an idea of the sound volume difference. And if you're a person that has wanted a GCEA baritone, I didn't like the tension of that. The tension is greater. As you go larger, the tension does generally increase with the larger of the instrument that you have. But anyway, here's the baritone for me. To playing baritone either. Concert is my main instrument that I pull most of the time. So when I'm playing baritones, there are times that I go to the wrong spot because the reach is longer. Both of them, excellent, clean built, well-made, affordable entry-level ukuleles from an established brand that uses a dealer network. So there you have it. The Flight NUB310, the Flight NUT310, both really nice entry-level laminate mahogany ukuleles if you're interested. All right, thanks so much for joining me for this video. I hope you're having a great day, and I'll be back soon with some more Uke stuff for you.